Hey guys, does your tow haul mode not work anymore? Today we're gonna fix it. An inoperable tow hold mode button is pretty common for a GMT-800 by now, so that's 1999 to 2007 classic. On automatic transmissions, doesn't matter if you have a V6 or a V8, they're all going to come standard with this button over here. What this does is it changes the programming for the transmission, so when you're hauling a load in the back or you're towing a trailer, the truck can deal with it easier. So all it is there's two wires that are in the shifter here, and they go down. The problem is, with wiring doesn't like to move, but it has to in this situation. So as you're shifting over the years, maneuvering the truck, whatever, the more this goes back and forth, it starts to wear out the wire, and then eventually it will break. So the first thing we have to do is take off the steering column cover. So we're going to go ahead and remove this column adjustment. So just pull hard on that, that'll come out. Next, we have to pull off the cover itself. So I'll reach in here with my finger and pull it down, grab my pry tool, and then begin to work my way around. So it's hinged in the back, focus on the middle and towards the steering wheel first. You're probably going to have to move the dash bezel to give yourself some more room. So just go ahead, pull it forward. Sash it out. I have a plug in mine that's aftermarket. I put a plug here for it. We're sashing this around the gauge cluster, and then that allows us to pull it out. Get more of that stuff out of the way. We're going to push down a little bit, get this out, exposing all our wiring and our mechanism. Looking at the shifter linkage and the mechanism, we can see this orange sheath over here. The plug's buried in here. I'd recommend that you remove the lower dash to get easier access. The lower cover is easy to remove. It's just 2 7-millimeter bolts. So the way I like to take it out is just a swift tug on each side. Let's tackle the cable first. I'm going to remove this little support clip. And don't forget this. And you can clearly see where the wire is broken over here. Take our screwdriver. Go ahead and take our screwdriver. Now to remove the actual shifter, T3 Torx. With that faster move, you just go ahead and pull it out. So I like to inspect further. We can see that there's a break in the line. Typically what I would do is I do a continuity test for you guys, but obviously we're not going to have any continuity on this. Now, there are replacement parts available from the OEM and in the aftermarket, which is totally fine to do. But the only thing that I'm afraid of is if you're going to put in a part with the exact same specifications, you're probably going to have the same problem again, which it might take 10 years to occur, so not a big deal. What I'm deciding to do is, because I have some leftover high quality wire here, so it's very malleable, it's a high strand count, even though it is a thinner gauge, I'm just going to extend it and give me a little bit more room, so as it's articulating in there, I'm probably not going to have the issue again. So the sheath is pretty tough, but you can get it open. So we're going to cut back our wire where it's good and then insert our new wire. So upon further inspection with the insulation off, it is multi-strand, but it's very thin and weak. So this is thin wire for me. This is 18 gauge, but you can see how much more thick it is. You could put a 20 gauge onto this, but because I have a lot of room to maneuver this, I'm gonna go with the 18 gauge and get a little more durability. This is the first stage of our repair. I have the wire extended, I have it soldered, and I have it shrink wrapped. So I am using shrink tubing with glue inside. So the two things, it's gonna help insulate it, and the glue helps hold the connection together as well. It's being a bit redundant. So what I'm also gonna do is I'm going to use exterior Tessa tape because it's more durable than interior. So what I like to do is keep it open like that, wrap it onto itself so the adhesives meet each other, and then we can do a tight wrap after that. It's up to you if you guys want to use vinyl tape, interior Tessa, use something automotive rated. I'm just doing this because this is what I know how it works. I know what's going to do in the vehicle. So I'm gonna wrap once more around it. So here's my final fix. So now it is extended, it has exterior tests on it, and we're using solder and shrink wrap with glue in it. So it's gonna be a lot more durable. The main thing is it's going to articulate now from the new, more durable wire. So I'm trying to get my connections away because we've technically added more points of failure in theory, because now we have 1, 2, 3, 4 connections with the extension as opposed to buying a whole new piece. But what I'm thinking is because we're articulating now on the new, more durable wire, I think this is the better fix. So take it for what it is. If you guys want to do this, by all means, do it this way. If you're not comfortable with it, go get the aftermarket piece or go get the OEM piece and just replace it. It took about 240,000 kilometers for my truck to actually experience the failure. So if you put the OEM piece in without doing this, you'll be fine. Before we put it back together, the original Faster had blue thread lock on it, so we're gonna reapply it ourselves again. So now we're essentially doing everything in reverse. You'll wanna counter the shifter as you're tightening it. I just snug it down. So I want you guys to see now with our new fix how it articulates. So you can see, because our loop has come all the way around, it doesn't have that same issue. Let's look at it from this vantage point. So here's our wire. You see it come down. Sorry, it's hard to see that boot there. So the wire that is interacting with the metal here is our new wire in the Tessa. But it's not really rubbing against it, it's just kind of pushing down a little bit. If this wire to break, we know where to fix it, but I think this is going to be a lot more durable than the original setup. Another test you want to do with your wiring is check the tilt. Make sure everything is moving freely. And we can see now when I push the button, our tow haul mode works again. Now I did spray a little bit of fluid film in the moving components. However, for those of you that drive on dusty roads, I would skip that step. If you're thinking about, oh, I should lubricate a little bit more in here. If everything's working fine, I wouldn't, because if the dust gets inside the cabin, if you're driving with your door, with your windows open, you're just gonna cake everything in the interior. Now, when you're putting it back together, you have to make sure everything is lining up. It's a bit difficult on these, because this cover goes under the steering wheel and you're trying to maneuver it. So you might have to get under the steering wheel, raise it back up, line everything in. If anything's bent, it's not gonna wanna click together. Once you have all the panels back together, you put in the last piece. All right, let's go ahead and test it. So in park, tow haul mode, reverse, neutral, drive, neutral, reverse, park, Also, when you leave tow haul mode on, when I turn off the truck and I turn it back on, it will not engage. It's supposed to disengage every time you turn off the vehicle, and you have to re-engage it every time you start driving again. So there you guys have it. The culprit's probably gonna be a broken wire 9 times out of 10. It is possible you're gonna have a faulty switch, so always do a continuity test if the wire checks out just fine. Now, there is a possibility if you guys want, if you were looking to change out this column, now's the time if you wanna buy something new. You can put in a Denali one or an Escalade one if you want. Also, when you're taking apart these GM panels, warm them up if it's cold out. If you do it at room temperature, even better, because they're a little bit dried out, that they might crack. And there is also a high possibility when you put these covers back on, you might have a slight gap after. They're very hard to put back on and have everything aligned. But hopefully that helps you guys out.